The following presentation does not represent Australian opinion or intellect. We do not speak for any religious order or ethnic minority. We are not political scientists or uni graduates. We're insignificant upper lower class scum, comparing notes and airing grievances. It's just our opinion. Deal with it.
So GST will ever be part of our policy.
Never ever.
It's dead.
Go back to where they're from.
It is a big idea.
No, we don't need them.
A new world order. By 1990, no Australian child will be living in...
You weren't going to take the PS4 back. I said, just leave it in the dojo. And I said, forget it, dickhead. I go, this isn't secure.
Yeah, just take it with you. Like.
I go, no one's ever here. Like,
we went and bought AFL.
Yeah, we had AFL.
It's there.
Yeah, but that was for PS3.
Yeah, no, we didn't have FIFA on PS3. We had FIFA on PS4.
PS4.
Really?
Yeah. I'm almost positive.
What are you, shattered?
I just don't remember bringing the...
I'm, dude,
do you remember much about the first 30 episodes?
I'm almost positive that it was FIFA...
PS4.
FIFA 16 on PS4, because I went and got FIFA 17, and that was the big thing.
And now you've got 18.
Yeah.
Are there any other games anywhere?
Just Fight Night and AFL.
All we had was Fight Night AFL. That was it. I don't think we ever played anything else in here.
Spewing.
Why?
Not like FIFA.
So, was I say, you know, you said Napoleon Dynamite, Uncle Rico's always eating the steak?
Eating the meat, yeah.
Yeah, you know he's a vegetarian, the actor?
Oh, is he?
Yeah, if you watch certain scenes, like, you know the one when he throws the football at, is it Napoleon that he throws the football at? Hits him in the side of the head?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, he actually spits out the meat right before he goes to turf the ball.
Oh.
Yeah, he's actually like a vegetarian. He hated doing those things. He's only chewing, you never see him swallow.
Like Krusty with the Krusty Burger.
Cut.
Feed people this stuff.
Yeah, man. Krusty.
Krusty Burger, man.
What's the law? I love Krusty.
It's been happening.
Nothing. I was just going to say, I bought... Fuck. I'm afraid I'm going to yank...
Disconnect it?
Yeah, every time.
Well, what goodies have you got for us today?
I bought clips, finally, so we can put up Kenny G.
Yeah. I see there's a nice little sticker on there.
Oh, yeah. You like that one?
How dare you deface my laptop like that?
I know. I did it on purpose as well. I did it on purpose.
After the hundreds of times you've defaced it.
covered up the forbidden fruit on the front panel.
Yeah.
Asshole.
Well, fuck this brand.
And now it's just a laptop.
Now it's just a laptop.
It doesn't even glow through it.
Nah.
That's how weak
this
it is.
Stickers are matte.
That's some thick stickers you ordered.
Thick stickers.
Two mil stickers.
You love how I had to go out to Knoxfield to go get the fucking stickers.
Yeah, man. Yeah. You said the air was fresh out my way.
I messaged a printer. I'm like, hey, man, did you end up sending them? I'm like, fuck, what the fuck? Yeah, I did. Like, what happened? And then I got home at work, like, after work at like 8:30. And then one of those, we missed you fast track things.
Mm-hmm.
I just saw it. It's sort of Knoxfield. I went, oh, get fucked. That depot has not changed in 2 years. I went, like,
same faces,
dude,
same.
2.5 years, because when I ordered my my car indicators, I bought my car, 2015, so when I got my indicators, they were meant to go there, I actually beat the driver out. He left one of those
That's
notes.
Right,
in,
yeah.
Yeah, he left one of the notes in my mailbox. I literally waited all morning outside the front of my building, never rocked up, left for like 20 minutes to go buy milk, came back, and there was one of those stickers. I'm like, oh, hell no. So I called him up, got the driver's details. Like, where are you? Oh, I'm driving around. Okay, listen here. Okay, you're going to pull in at that Noble Macca's, because there's no way I'm going out to Knoxfield again.
It's weird they took it all the way out to Knoxfield. Like, normally when I get a card left, it's just
local
like...
depot.
Yeah, but that's actually Australia Post.
Okay. This is,
who was it? Fast Track.
Or Fastway? Couriers?
Fastway.
Fastway Courier.
Yeah.
These are the pricks that like, make you sit. Yeah.
Yeah. They sent me out to that depot like 100 times.
Didn't you pick up your bag from there as well?
Yeah, dude. I went there to pick up the, what did I get? I'd ordered something. I don't remember what it was.
A duffel bag to hold your guns in.
No, I didn't even order the duffel bag, dude.
Anal dildo.
Anal dildo. Like, is it any other?
You're fucked.
Vibrating.
Like, specifically anal.
Bunny ears.
Yeah. Hang on.
Beads.
Put these clips here, because we're going to forget them.
Smaller to larger beads.
Like a gradient? You're disgusting, man.
Level
Why
of...
Why are you staring at me like that?
Level of...
Dude, these beady eyes.
Level of confidence.
It's just zoning in on me as he's saying small to large beads.
Just raping you with my eyes.
Oh, God, no, cover up. I'm only wearing a singlet here.
If you start feeling dirty, there's a shower back there.
Dude, I'm telling you, you're going to scrub just in the fetal position.
You increase the bead size in relevance with your confidence.
So it's confidence that determines how much crap your ass can take.
Pretty much.
You're disgusting.
Gotta suck it up sometimes.
You seem pretty confident.
I know, you seem pretty confident. No. Forget that shit. Dude,
anyway,
I'd gone to Fastway. They'd left the card. They didn't even come to my building. They bypassed me. They've got a depot in Port Melbourne somewhere, and they've got that depot in Knoxfield. They basically didn't rock up, didn't send me anything.
They were scared of drive-bys, so they just carried on.
Dude, they didn't even leave me a card. I waited, because I got the message saying your delivery's on its way or whatever. Called them up. See, where the hell is it? I spent some like 40 minutes on the phone. And like, oh, yeah, it's at our... We've lost the package. We'll let you know when it turns up. And then I finally called them again because they never called me back. And like, oh, yeah, it's at Knoxfield. Okay, it never even got to my house. Like, they literally just took it from the docks in Port and took it straight to Knoxfield without even just bypassing.
So they probably thought, you know what, we're right here.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't worry about Noble Park. Just dogs. Take the freeway and go to Knoxfield.
Yeah. He wasn't home, do you agree? Yes.
Okay. I tracked it down. I went out to Knoxfield to pick it up. I can't remember what I was buying, but I get there.
Is it down on Rushdale Street or something like that?
Nah, off Ferntree, is it Ferntree Gully Road?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you just go straight. You pass the Thai restaurant and the gym,
mm-hmm.
where that AAA supplements billboard is, where mm-hmm. the baseball field is. Mm-hmm. You nailed it.
Yeah, Rushdale.
Yeah, that you go down past that, and then you turn right. It's sort of like a...
Yeah, industrial area.
Yeah, what they usually call them like Commercial Drive or, Industrial Way or like they've got names like that. Yeah.
We used to drag down there.
Yeah, it's a nice drag area. Dude, my indoor thing is just up the road from there. Like, indoor is literally another 40 metres up.
And then when you get bored of dragging, you just like mosey on over to the baseball fields and just start ripping it up.
Yeah, make a bomb. But one guy's lighting a billy, the other guy's just doing toys. Standard Friday night in the gully. But dude, I got to that.
Drifting from home base to home base. Sideways around all the pads.
In a TX3 or a Telstar.
Something, whatever I had.
Yeah.
Swift. Lancer.
What's it called? I got to that depot and.
You let it fly. Right
there. There's a fly there in front of you. It's on your hands now. Now it's above my head. Now it's gone to the window.
Just went into Jim's fly. What the hell?
What?
Get it out.
No, leave it in.
I go to that fucking depot. I hand over my details. She comes back after 5 minutes, and she's got, like, two packages. I'm like, what the hell is this? She goes, what you ordered. I go, huh? So I've looked at it, pulled out the first one, and it was, like, a car part of some kind. I can't remember what it was. And then the second one was that duffel bag you're talking about. I'm like, what the hell is this? She goes, they were both under your name. They both had your name on it. I'm like, man, the duffel bag, I never even got a note for. I never got a fucking phone call from.
Nothing.
I ordered it, like, off eBay for $20 and forgot about it. And then went there and they had it sitting there.
Wow.
Like, another day or two and they would have sent it back to the
really
sender.
They're really shit. They're really shit
Those
couriers,
lazy
man.
Fucking couriers.
Dude, how fucked is that?
Fastway is really bad, man.
Like, they're shit.
I'm calling it. Like, they're one of the worst, man.
Easily.
We had them at an old job. I'd rock up whenever they've... Like, I needed an urgent parcel sent to, like, the CBD or whatever, and I was working in Brighton. And it's like, oh, yeah, we'll roughly be there between 1 and 2. I'm like, all right, guy rocks up at 3:30. He's like, dude, like, seriously, by the time you get it there, it'll be close of business. And he's like, oh, I'm just busy and stuff. His van was empty.
Where the fuck are my anal beads?
Oh, his van was empty. Guy's just selling everything off.
Another shit one is Amalgamated. They're not good.
Who are they?
Another courier company.
I've never heard of them. Amalgamated.
Yeah.
That's the name of the company.
Yeah.
Couldn't pick a more like, convoluted name. Amalgamated.
Hmm.
That rolls off the tongue. Just, remember that company, Amalgamated.
Who do you refer to? Amalgamated.
What? How do you spell that?
Amalg.
No, but that's Fastway. Anyway, I got the fucking stickers and the, what was the other thing? Stickers and cards. Oh, they're all in my car. I'm a dickhead. You parked in front of me just now. It's all right. I'll give you a sample.
Yeah, sweet.
A sample?
Yeah.
He'll stick them all over. You know what? Tomorrow you're going to the ice skating rink, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Stick them on their window.
I'll just throw them on the ice.
So they get wet and just crumble.
So people will just have to see them, trip on them and be like, oh.
Just stick them on the window. I'll listen to that. Just slap the door or something.
Nah, you got to be careful, because then you get done for vandalism or defacing public property or private property.
Maybe just ask them then.
That's why you can only really say, the only way you can get away with it is by saying that we gave them out, to students or whatever, and they're putting them up. It's not my problem.
There you go.
Put a bunch in my pocket, accidentally fall over and spill them out onto the ice and then just hurry off.
Without the backs on them, so they stick on the actual ice.
Yeah.
You're an idiot. Just one hobo.
And then he looks over it.
Yeah. You're the only one in there as well, just going round and round.
Throwing stickers in the air.
What were you saying? I didn't quite see the message last week when you said you'd... Because I was doing the edit. You said something about the goalie from that was on the ice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't really follow it because I was doing the edit, so I was only caught wind of it, and then I forgot to ask you about it. What the hell happened?
Me and Drummond were just talking about it before you got here, before you were late again.
Before I was late again.
Basically, there was a guy there, just kind of like...
I can't be fucked.
He was like a nerdy dude, and he was like had the full get-up on, like the full goalie get-up. Big pads, the hat lifted up, some sort of vest. He even had the stick. He was holding the stick.
I was a keeper. He has to have a stick.
Yeah, but it was just like... The rink was full of, like, kids and mums.
What was he doing?
Practicing.
Showing off his skills, basically. Like,
thought he was, like...
Was anyone actually taking shots at him?
No. He was just, like, in the centre. Just, like, literally showing off.
In the centre?
Yeah.
I thought you said he was at the goals.
No. There were no goals set up. He was just, like, drilling. It was really, really awkward.
This is one for Clark Danza. You'll know what I mean. In England, they're what they call them. Full kit wankers.
Yeah.
Full kit wankers, man.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he'd, like, do these, like, real elegant spins with his stick real low and then, like, come up, like...
Full uniform, full everything.
I felt embarrassed, like, for him, like...
I love how he felt embarrassed for him.
Yeah, because it was just like, dude, just stop it.
So it was by himself?
By himself, yeah.
And there was kids everywhere. Yeah, and that's weird.
He kept an eye on me, and every time I came past, he'd, like, show off his skills just to show me what he had.
Why don't you kick him? What was he doing?
It was, like, imagine, like, standing, like, front on and then, like, doing, like, a little... Quick, like, 5 steps to the left, and then, like, a quick stop.
Like a goalie would, you know, like an ice hockey goalie. Like, he'd be...
Oh, like shuffling.
Quick movements.
Then twirl out of that, and then do 5 little side steps to the right, and do a quick little stop, like a little...
Okay, so he was doing a full, like, kit, yeah, full kit drill by himself.
Yeah.
What a wanker.
When there's fucking kids everywhere.
Yeah.
School holidays.
That's wanky.
It's school holidays, man.
I get the point of doing full kit drills, right? Like, so you're simulating game.
Go to the side of the rink. Don't you stand
in the center of a ring.
But not even in the center. Sometimes it was like right in the way of like where people were.
That's what I'm saying. Like, go where people aren't gonna. Like, you know what I mean? Like, just or go later at night when this kid's not gonna be there.
Yeah, like, dude. It's only open like public 12 till 3, so he could have done something like after that.
Especially if he's part of the team there, like because they've got.
I think he must have been.
Then he gets time. Yeah.
Yeah. Then he'll. Be able to go after.
Getting time on the ice isn't an issue if you're, like, part of the team.
Exactly. Yeah. Melbourne Ice, whatever they're called. What are they called? Melbourne Ice?
I don't know. I didn't
That's what the team's called.
Melbourne Ice? That's not an indicator we've got a drug problem.
Dude, I'm telling you. Melbourne Ice.
Dude, ice is Melbourne's drug of choice. We're like the ice capital of Australia. Seriously? Didn't they call a hockey team Melbourne Ice?
They are called the Melbourne Ice.
They're the ones at Oakley, yeah?
Yeah, the ones at Oakley. Melbourne Ice.
Ironically enough, I guarantee you ice gets dealt out of that front car park like, all the time. No, I'm serious. There are no cameras there. It's right in the hub of the southeast. It's 2 minutes down from Macca's.
It formerly played at Olympic Ice Skating Arena in Oakley. They've moved to...
Docklands?
Yeah, O'Brien Group Arena.
Because I know they've got another team because you can... They got the scoreboard set up and you can do, like, training, like ice hockey training and stuff. So, I think they have...
Tell you what, though, they're pretty good, man. Like, they've been smashing cunts all over the...
Yeah, but who have they been playing?
Teams around Australia.
Yeah, but
they full travel. Like, they're proper, like
friend of mine that's a figure skater, she was talking about it and saying how there really isn't much of a competition here. Like, they go overseas and just get drilled.
Mm.
And every now and then they'll bring in Canadians or something to come down and just destroy us. It's like, well, yeah, man.
Reality check.
Yeah, like... It's like the Kenyans that, you know, go and do swimming. It's like, dude, you got no swimming pools. Dude, that's like Simpsons again, full circle. And it's the same episode with the Krusty Burgers. When that's the Olympics and the Americans, obviously, and they're off. And the Americans shoot out to an early lead. Mind you, Ken, we should remind viewers at home that the rest of the competitors are from countries that don't have swimming pools. What? They're all drowning.
Dog paddling in
treading
water.
In their lives.
I found the teams. I found the comp. You got Melbourne Ice.
Oakley Wombats.
Nah.
For an ice hockey team. Pick an animal that's out in bush.
The Oakley Orangutans.
Yeah, man.
Melbourne Ice. Melbourne Mustangs. That one.
What does that have to do with fucking
the Sydney Bears?
Okay.
What the fuck is this flight problem?
Man. You got more tin or something?
Nah.
Maybe we should open that window to let it out.
To let his mates in.
Boys, party up, man.
Newcastle North Stars. Sydney Ice Dogs.
North Stars.
Sydney Ice Dogs.
Ice Dogs. Like the Tap Dogs, but Ice Dogs.
Perth Thunder. DBR Brave.
Isn't Thunder a cricket team?
Yeah, Sydney. In Sydney.
Yeah. Perth Thunder is an ice hockey team, and then the Sydney Thunder is a big fash league
thing. Adelaide Adrenaline.
Ooh. What about the Blizzards? That'd be a good name.
Yeah.
The Gully Blizzards.
The Canberra Knights, Gold Coast Blue Tongues.
Blue Tongues as in lizards?
Yeah.
They'd be terrible on the ice.
Yeah. Adelaide Avalanche. Avalanche, snow.
Why whatever. Can't they have, like...
And then, this is the worst one. The Central Coast Rhinos. What the fuck? Sounds like a rugby team.
And once again, a rhino would not do well on the ice.
Africa, and they're putting it on the ice.
An animal that's never seen ice.
The animal has never seen ice. Literally never.
I could beat a rhino on the ice. Yeah, what a stupid name.
Those are the dumbest names. What are the names in the NHL League? Detroit Red Wings, the Anaheim... Yeah.
You got Pittsburgh...
Penguins. The Bruins. The Flyers.
Maple Leafs, like Toronto.
Yeah, Toronto, Maple Leafs. But that's Flyers, because that's their thing. The Giants.
The Jets, the Stars.
Yeah.
No, not the Giants.
No, wait, the Giants is a baseball team.
You got the Ducks. No,
Giants is
the
in
Ducks.
It.
The Ducks slide on ice when it's winter.
That's true.
Yeah, but dude, the Rhinos, the Central Coast Rhinos.
Yeah, that just doesn't make sense. Why?
Where's that? What area is Central Coast?
So, like, New South Wales, but along the coast.
But isn't Sydney along the coast?
Yeah, no, but they call that area Central Coast, like near Newcastle, up that way, but a bit higher, I think.
So in between Queensland and New South.
Yeah, so that'd be like Central Coast.
Bumtown.
I'm just picturing
Bumtown.
I'm picturing dusty farms and bogans that have never set foot on ice, ever.
We're the Rhinos.
Yeah, the Central Coast Rhinos.
Maybe that's what it is. They're just that shit. It's just like we need a name that just shows how shit we are.
So when you get like the Mud Dogs... Yeah, like in, what is it? The Water Boy. They're called the Mud Dogs. Mm. I was thinking about that the other day. The Mud Dogs.
The Huskies. Don't you go the Huskies?
The Huskies? You're a dickhead.
Don't you go the Whitewash?
I was trying to pick. There was, it's also, what's it called? You remember the movie Major League?
Mm. Yeah, with Charlie Sheen.
Yeah, the first one and the second one. In the first one, their coach is selling tires out of like a Bob Jane T-Mart or something, like a shitty tire joint. Before they, like, someone calls him and says, "Hey, do you want to come and coach?" He's like, "I'm waiting on a deal for a couple of white walls." Like, yeah, clearly more important selling tires than coaching a major league baseball team. But
somehow they win.
Yeah, the team that he was coaching was called the something Mud Hens.
Mud Hens?
Yeah, it was from a fucking... And the place... I always... The place that... The town or city or whatever that he was representing... always like
Alabama or something? Down that way?
I don't know what... The place always sticks out whenever I hear it. Like that... Is it the Toledo Mud Hens? I think it's the Toledo Mud Hens. Hang on.
You got a good memory. I would not have a clue.
Dude, I'm telling you, it's just one of those references. Yeah, it is the Toledo Mud Hens. Hang on.
What's a mud hen?
Well, that's why it stuck out, because I remember watching it.
Is there such a thing as a mud hen?
Yeah, Lou Brown, the manager of the Cleveland Indians, managed in Toledo prior to managing the Indians. And then Richard Pryor in... This is why I remembered it, because Richard Pryor in the movie Brewster's Millions with John Candy, he pitched for the Mud Hens as well. The Toledo Mud Hens. And I always think about Toledo. Mm. I don't know why. I've always wanted to go. It's in Ohio. Yeah, that I don't know why.
You guys watch ice hockey?
Oh, so a mud hen...
Watch what? Ice hockey?
Dude, the mud hen is basically, the picture here, it looks like a duck. Yeah, it's a duck. Although it swims like a duck, it's also called an American coot.
Coot?
A coot. The American coot does not have webbed feet like a duck.
So it's just a deformed duck.
So it's a non-webbed duck. The American coot.
So the American coot got ripped.
The gully coots.
The gully coots.
Yeah, so a mud
hen. Gully gazelles.
So there mud hen, that makes sense.
Gazelles for ice. So a mud hen is a duck without webbed feet.
Yeah.
What a rip.
Does it have a beak like a duck?
It looks exactly like a duck.
Without webbed feet?
Yeah.
Somewhere along the line, it got like...
Evolution is a motherfucker, man. That's fucked. NHL. No, you, I don't watch it.
NHL? Do you watch it?
Yeah, I got the live pass.
He loves it. He loves it.
Really?
You got a pass. NHL's pretty cool. I get it on Fox at home. So I watch it every now and then on Fox.
Yeah, basically, they had a special on it. It was like $39 for the rest of the season. So I just got it so I can just watch the occasional game every now and then.
Yeah, but is that for gambling purposes, or is that for you actually like watching it?
A little from column A, a little from column B. You know what I made my million.
For gambling purposes.
Seriously? Just investing into NHL.
You buy a life pass in NHL so you can gamble more. Gamble more efficiently and accurately.
You can actually watch what's going on.
Yeah, you can actually, like, just watch and see, the park. You can cash out, yeah. Eventually, I want to have it so there's, like, three screens set up with three different sports. As I'm
Me and your brother used to talk about that all the time, like, 5 years ago.
He's going to quit work. He's going to become a professional
gambler. At work, when you go up to, in our side where the dunnies are, right? You go up and there's, like, a little locker room sort of area, the dunnies, yada, yada. And there's a little, where the cleaners, the janitor's cupboard is, next to it is, like, a little allocated side area. I think there's a shower in there.
Yeah, there is. There's a couple.
Yeah, but there's but they're disgusting. Like, you wouldn't shower in there ever. And it's like this barbed wire cage around it.
Yeah.
It's not exactly inviting. It literally looks like a prison shower.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, there's no tiles. It just looks like bare concrete.
It's kind of shower you'd wear your jocks into. And then thongs.
You'd wear a knight's suit of armor.
It's like a scene out of Saw.
Yeah. It looks dark and dank.
No one wants to clean it.
Because no one uses it. I don't know why, but it's literally like a chain link fucking door.
Yeah.
Like they ripped it off a construction site or something.
With a padlock on there.
Yeah. Someone gets locked in the shower.
Stay a while. Stay forever.
But me and his brother always used to say we'd set up an off-track bedding in there, and you go in there and there'd be like three big iPads like on the wall with just the dogs, the footy, and then the tennis.
David, you got your little black book?
Yeah, and like a desk.
Oh, fuck.
Me and Mick was saying it as well, because there's always certain heads you run into at certain times. Like, I always run into all the time at like 10 to 11, like standard. Every time we used to see each other, we just laugh, because you go up there for a breath of fresh air, ironically enough, in the fucking toilet area, just to get away from the floor.
Where are you working, man?
The air is not fresh, Adam.
Nah, it's
where
fine.
The hell are you guys working? Fuck!
Yeah, it's Auschwitz, man. But every time I'd run into Mick, I'm like, you again? I'm like, yeah. He's like, hey, man, it's almost like you need to have one of the, you need like a rope, you know, like at a club, letting cunts in and out. I'll set up a little desk, and I'll book you in for a shit at like 12:40. Yeah, sweet. That cubicle's free.
A little glory hole where you pass the money through.
Money to use a toilet.
Comes through on the end of a cock.
Those toilets are fucked. I know there's the graffiti that goes up in toilets. Like, those toilets always get graffiti up, like, on the tiles and shit.
Mm.
Do you ever read this graffiti when you went to public toilets as a kid?
Yeah.
Wait, call for a good time.
Yeah. That always used to fascinate the fuck out of me.
Hey,
because we'd go on the road trips, like, you know, Mildura or whatever, and there's truck stops everywhere. So you go to take, like, your old man will yell at you. It's like, hurry up, we've got 5 minutes. Yeah, 5 minutes, like, to get out of the car, stretch your legs, take a leak, and get back in the car. Like, seriously?
It always used to be so horrifying, the shit you'd read on the walls.
Yeah.
Like, it used to, like, you'd, like, really, like, hit you deep. You'd be like, shit.
Yeah.
This world's fucked. That's when I knew something was wrong.
Wrong?
When you read the shit on the toilet wall.
That's when I knew just something was not right in this world. Now, do you know what I mean? Like it was really confronting back when you were little, like, reading some of the shit, like...
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, suck. Even if it just said, suck my dick or something, you're just like, oh, my God.
What would it take someone to actually write that on a toilet wall? Like, I love graffiti, but who the fuck would write that? Like, why...
Yeah, imagine, actually.
Why would you write that on a toilet wall? Like, really? You're like, okay, that's going to change my life while I'm trying to... You know what I mean? Like, suck my dick. Or, like, when you see the random phone numbers go up,
yeah.
Call this number for a good time. Like, really, dude?
It's for, like, some guy's ex-missus.
Yeah. And it's there from, like, 50 years ago.
I'm calling you for a good time.
Yeah. Hello? Some old fart.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I was thinking about? How, now that you said that, I was thinking about, you know, we were talking about the yes vote or whatever, and you said that someone we work with was like, oh, they should just make the rule, whatever it is. And
just stick to it.
That should be it. Dude.
As in, like, the vote for yes or no.
Yeah,
the
vote for yes or no, and it should not incorporate anything else, and that's, like, the bile and end all.
They should stick to the rules and not sway for anyone.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you open up the door for too many other things, yeah.
Dude, society is meant to change rules as we progress. We've been changing rules since the beginning of time.
Yeah.
Like, he's a Christian, right? Dude, didn't the Christians become about because of a Jew? Judaism was created somewhere, like, it didn't just exist from, like, the beginning of time.
Yeah.
Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, according to his theory, then, like, how are you a Christian? Because you took ever-evolving, changing rules.
Mm.
Like, am I making any sense?
Mm-mm.
It came up because I was talking to my cousin at Christmas Eve, And he was talking about all the old wogs, how they, all the Greeks, how they get, they start losing it about the Jewish presence or whatever in something. And he's like, dude, every time you go into a church, you bow to a Jewish king. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Jewish.
Oh, that's different. Like, how's it different?
It's not different.
Yeah.
It's exactly what it is.
Yeah. And that really got me thinking, man, about how, like, this guy's like, oh, just make the rules and that's it. It's like, well, no, you can't just, like, otherwise slavery would still be going on. Civil rights would never have come about.
Men would still be backhanding their women if they got out of line.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That were the days.
No, but do you understand what I'm saying?
One of these days.
One of these days, Alice. One of these days. Pow! Right in the kisser. Jackie Gleason.
Yeah, man.
Dude, that was on TV.
Oh, was it?
Really?
Jackie Gleason. Yeah, you don't know what that is? That's from The Honeymooners.
I just
know. Was it recently?
No. Like,
oh, yeah, man.
Yeah, but that was his actual
show. That was accepted, yeah.
That was accepted on TV.
He like, threatened her.
A man would threaten his wife every day with a menacing fist.
I just know it from Family Guy.
Yeah, that's where they got it from.
Yeah.
And who was it? Was it... Who's... He ended up... Being someone's banging someone's. It was in one of the first seasons of Family Guy.
Yeah, I'm not really that big a fan of Family
Guy. She walked in on her mum with Jackie Gleason.
Wait, it was the wife, wasn't
it? It was Lois's mother.
Yeah,
Lois walked in on her mum with Jackie Gleason. Pow! Right in the kisser.
Yeah, I'm gonna go find the photo.
In black and white, I think.
Yeah, he's sitting on the bed with the sock suspenders and the postman hat.
Pow, right in the kisser.
I thought about that, man, because it's like this guy that we know from work is an educated guy, like he's not an idiot, but that's what his mentality's at. So then you wonder how society gets to that warp, because that's a nice version of whatever's going on. Dude, do you see the bust up that just happened now in the States about that family, the extreme Christian family, had their 30 kids fucking
locked 30 up.
Yeah, it's like 15, 16 kids. All chained to beds.
Beds, man.
You didn't read about it?
Fucked up, man.
Is this
man.
The Westboro or whatever?
No. This is independent of the Westboro, man. Hang on.
This is the extreme.
Yeah, dude. Wait a second. It's just on the news, like, now. Like, literally 2 days, yesterday and today.
Far right, Westboro.
Where is it? Hang on. If you look it up, fuck. Just go to news.com. What am I doing?
There's this one. Right?
What's that?
And then it's got... Lois's mum going down on Jackie Gleason on Family Guy.
Yeah, man.
There you go. One of these days.
Pow!
Right in the kisser.
Oh, where the fuck is it? Chain children. Here we go. You haven't heard about this? The Turpin family.
Turpin?
Yeah, look it up. Turpin family. Neighbors of the Turpin family in Paris, California have described their odd behavior and heartbreak and not realizing what was happening in the middle of their community. Dude, it was a family, right? There were 13 kids, and, the parents, David Allen Turpin, 57, and Louise Ann Turpin, 49, were arrested on suspicion of 9 counts of torture and 10 counts of child endangerment. They're being held at bail. Their bail set at $9 million each. Like, so there's no way that, like, they could leave.
What did they do?
What did they do? They had 13 kids.
Oh, that's the kids there? Try and show me a picture.
They're about to cover their faces because they're underage.
Yeah. All of them are younger... All of them are underage.
And they're all numbered.
Innocent newborns.
They're all
numbered.
They all lived, dude, as things, yeah? Dude, look at this. This is in Vegas at a family photo. They all had identical haircuts, identical clothes, like, all the time. Only left at night.
Skirts well below the knee.
Yeah.
I may add.
Same outfits and haircuts. That was when they were renewing their wedding vows. Yeah. Look at this guy, man. Fucking...
Oh.
Dude, they're fucked.
It looks like fucking,
Beatles.
Look at this monster. No,
it's like a monster.
No, what's that movie?
Monster?
No.
Found Inc. Several
Monsters Inc.
The cops, the Riverside County Sheriff's, found several children shackled to their beds with chains and padlocks in a dark and foul-smelling surroundings. Literally,
that's fucked up.
These cunts would lock their kids up on beds and not let them do shit. Like, literally,
protect them from the world.
Yeah.
I haven't heard anything. Like, that's bad, but that's not, like...
Dude, you shackled your 13 kids to a bed in a dungeon, dude.
Yeah, but, like, for how long and stuff, like...
For what are you about? 20 years!
Dude, you wouldn't do it in the first place. What are you talking about?
No, but, like, how long at a time does it say? Like, how long now?
All day.
Dude, as soon as they're born, they're shackled.
They weren't allowed out. They were forced to have, like, same haircuts, same everything, barely got to eat, had to sleep and sit in their shit.
Oh.
I'm trying to...
You're long?
Fucked.
No, no, I mean...
How are you not a cult leader by now? Seriously. No, that's normal.
No, no, it's not normal. But I mean, like, for, like, saying that they did something so horrible, just, like, shackling them to a bed.
Would you shackle your little girl to a bed?
I wouldn't do that.
Why not?
It's not right.
Not even for 2 seconds?
No.
Not even for a second?
No.
If you physically walked into your house and your little girl, I don't know, broke a vase and you just shackled her to a bed?
No,
in the dark.
I wouldn't do that.
So you're going to try and justify, like, even for 5 minutes?
No, but, like, what's happening to them? They're pretty much, what are they facing? Life in prison or something? Or
I don't know. Hang on. 13 Turpin children who aged from 2 to 29 were uncuffed from their beds.
29?
29 was the oldest one.
Holy shit!
Yeah.
And that kid wouldn't know anything
charged
about the outside
with
world.
Torture and child endangerment.
29?
Yeah.
Holy shit. That poor cunt fucking...
These cunts. The oldest one was 29. These are the mugshots that I saw.
Oh, yeah. Look at that
Scooby-Doo
guy.
Scooby-Doo, and she just... You know what? He beats her.
She's the Black Dahlia murderer. Yeah. Man. Like, seriously. Yeah. Apart from acting as his children's homeschooling principal, he was an engineer.
Homeschooling principal?
They homeschooled their children, dressed the 10 girls and 3 boys in matching outfits, all had, like, long, straight brown hair. Blah, 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 blah. The boys wore page boy cuts, similar to the style of their
Get
fathers.
Your quills out, children. Yeah. It's maths time.
He was registered as a principal of their homeschool, Sandcastle Day School, teaching first to 12th grade. He was also once an engineer for some security company. Declared bankrupt like 7 times or something. Blah, 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 blah. Moved around a bit.
What a fucked up individual.
Dude, they're fucked. Like, seriously. They're an extreme Christian family.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Gross.
Extreme Christian family. Yeah, they're all wearing thing 9, thing 12, like all their t-shirts are from the Cat in a Hat. They're wearing,
I like Dr. Zeus or whatever.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
There's a locket in my pocket.
Six months. Oh, keep their children locked up and surrounded by their own feces and urine.
Oh, okay, that's okay.
Can I have a shower? No.
Hang them up.
No, literally, dude, they were chained and padlocked to beds. The one... Dude, the young woman who police said was so emaciated that they thought she was aged 10, she escaped from the house and called the cops on a mobile. She was 17, but she looked 10. Like, that's how malnourished and shit she was.
And sheltered as well.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
The big difference between 17 and 10, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, but that goes on. That's a Christian family, an extreme Christian family. Locking up their fucking... And that's standard procedure for fucking some of these cults, dude. Like the Mormons or whatever, living in Westboro or, like... Any of those Mormon massive communities, like where it's just rife with incest and polygamy and shit, that's a Christian family living under the radar.
Well, you know what they say? Spare the rod, spoil the child, Dimitri.
Huh? Spare the rod, spoil the child. Like, corporal punishment's, like, out the window. But that's not corporal punishment, dude. That's sickness.
Yeah, that's not...
That's locking up your kids and shackling them in the beds.
They're shitting themselves and pissing themselves.
Yeah, and on days on end, treating them like animals.
Yeah, that's gross.
But they're under the guise of strict Christianity.
Dude, you wouldn't
God's
even...
God's way.
Dude, you wouldn't even treat fucking Spunk... What's your dog's name?
Spunky, yeah.
You wouldn't treat him like that.
Nah.
How long would you leave your dog tied up for?
He comes with...
That's
right.
What I'm saying.
Yeah.
You know, you can leave your dog... chained to the back fence for, like, 20 minutes while you're trying to do something to keep him out of his own harm.
If you cut the grass, just something. Yeah, just get out of the way.
Mm. But like I said, dude, you started off by, like, not defending it, but just trying to find, it's not that bad. It's like, well, how long would you leave your little girl shackled to a bed? Never. You wouldn't even think to do it. It's just inhumane.
Mm.
Doing it for 20 seconds is inhumane.
Imagine the poor 29-year-old guy.
Is it a guy or a girl?
I'm not sure.
That's fucked up, man.
Ugh.
Imagine being 29 and still don't have the strength or the brain function to, like, escape from a house.
And if he's been homeschooling him, he's been teaching him one thing and one thing.
Whatever, yeah, whatever.
He'd come into the real world and he'd be freaked out. He'd be scared. You'd be scared.
Of all the lies his dad would have told him.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Well, she had a mobile, though.
She managed to get a hold of a mobile. I don't know. She was 17.
But maybe she stole her parents' mobile. Whatever.
Maybe she found one or God knows what, whatever. She just managed to escape.
I wonder where the kids are going to go now.
Dude, they're going to need some serious psychological help, man.
Think about it, yeah? There's 15 kids... Kids, one's 29, one's 17.
It's a kid. Mentally,
yeah.
It'd be a kid.
They're children, right? 15 of them, and they couldn't escape the grip of, like, these two fuckwits.
House of Horrors,
He's,
man.
Like, 59 or 57, however old he was.
Power in numbers, kids. They should have fucking...
But that's what I'm saying. You'd think, like, with a group, you'd be able to, like, form some form of fucking...
Yeah, but if they've never been out and about...
Exactly.
He'd be God.
He'd be like the, he'd be, oh my God.
Yeah, he'd
like
be the keeper to all the keys and all the power.
If you were trying to escape, I'll kill you.
Yeah, and then you wonder how, like, these cults, whether they're Christian or Muslim or whatever they fall under, how they get this God complex, like how these leaders get this God complex and be able to control masses.
Mm.
If you're half charismatic, you know, and you give people a message of hope or whatever, then imagine that. Like, you can understand it, like, how it becomes about, but doesn't make it right. Like, dude, come on, man. Fucking 29-year-old shackled to a bed, too scared to fucking shit out of line.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
Yeah, and like I said, that's a reality. Imagine how long would you leave your little girl shackled to a bed. It doesn't matter what she did. She could have burnt your car down, you know, like, burnt your car inside out, burnt your house down, punched on with a neighbor. You wouldn't shackle her to a bed.
No.
Yeah.
Fucked up.
Yeah, man. But that's an extreme Christian family. They're doing God's work in their eyes. How deluded is that, man? I didn't even want to talk. I read that. I felt sick. I didn't want to read about it. I didn't want to talk about it.
Think about all the life you've lived up until 29 years of age and what you've done, what you've seen, where you've been.
Licking dick 24/7, Nicholas.
Yeah. Checking off in front of a mirror. Yeah, man.
But this kid, as we say.
29.
Has been shackled to a bed for his whole life.
Probably shackled his penis as well.
Well, doesn't know anything else other than whatever's inside that house and whatever his old man has told him.
You don't know if there's been sexual abuse?
They've been tortured. Apparently, they've been tortured. So, like, dude, getting chained to a bed and being left with no food and forced to shit on yourself? Dude, they don't do that in Guantanamo.
Nah.
How does, like...
Terrorists have got more rights.
Yeah.
How do you justify that in your head? Like,
I can't. What do you mean?
But that's sick. Like,
that's just dement. Like,
that's a sick.
I can't get my head around it right now. Yeah, there's no way.
That's a sick interpretation of, like, the Bible. In whatever.
If the guy's mentally challenged, then that's a whole other
thing. Dude, he's an engineer.
How's he mentally? He's quite.
He was an engineer for a security firm.
Idiot savant.
No, dude.
What's the excuse for his wife?
That doesn't make you twisted.
Getting bashed by him, so she just follows what he does.
Well, hang on. We can read the facts, like, if we just pull up a few articles rather than us speculate. But, dude, that's not just an isolated incident. That shit happens all the time. Whenever you hear about someone being imprisoned for, like, 20 years, it's never, like, an African or a Muslim family. Like, it's always this sort of shit. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, not always. I'm not going to go out and say it always.
Always.
No, but every time it pops up in the news, it's always some fucking white supremacist or some fucking extreme Catholic Christian cult or some shit. And they've got some girl locked in the basement that they're fucking abusing, forcing, like, they're raping every 24 minutes, you know, like, shit like that.
Hmm.
No, I'm serious, man.
That's fucked up.
Yeah. Like, I remember I was reading a case earlier, like, a week or two ago. I think I might screenshot it. It was about an Indian, I think they were South Asian in Sydney. Yeah, I won't say they're Indian just because, but they had a South Asian name. And they kept a woman like a virtual slave for like a couple of years or whatever. And she managed to escape or break free. And now she's suing them or like she's had them locked up.
Mm-hmm.
And they just basically kept her like a slave. Like she was forced to like cook and clean and do everything, watch their kids and do all that sort of shit for like little to no pay.
What, they Cinderella, Dimitri?
Yeah, and they were like, oh, what, you know, she was getting paid and, you know, there was never any complaints and blah, blah, blah. It's like, dude, she was a fucking virtual prisoner.
Yeah, can't do that. Can't do that.
But that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But they weren't, like, locking her to a fucking post and saying, shit in your own fucking, in your own bed. Here's a breadcrumb every 2 weeks, you know? These are your kids we're talking. These are, like...
Bowl of gruel.
Yeah, these are their kids we're talking about, though. It's not like they even kidnapped someone else's kid, you know? And like, and lived out some psycho fantasy like that, like Natasha. What was her name? The abductee. They became famous.
She ran away from in America.
Yeah. Hang on. I spend a lot of time reading about this sort of shit, man. Because it's fucking this girl.
Oh, you're talking about Schwitzel?
Schwitzel? No. This is Hang on. That this is in Austria.
Oh, Fritzl.
No, not Fritzl. This is someone else.
It's Fritzl.
She was abducted, by a psycho, whatever. 10-year-old girl, Natasha Kampuch. I can't remember how to pronounce her surname, right? She was abducted from her family home. She failed to arrive at school or come home. Then a witness reported having seen her being dragged into a white minibus by two men. A massive police effort, blah, 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 blah. Lives about half an hour away. Hang on. Speculations of child pornography rings, organ theft, yada, yada, yada. Captivity. During the 8 years of her captivity, she was held in a small cellar underneath the guy's garage. Entrance was concealed behind a cupboard. The cellar was only 5 square meters. The door was made of concrete, was reinforced with steel. The room had no windows and was soundproof. For the first six months of her captivity, she wasn't allowed to leave the chamber at any time. And for several years of her captivity, she was not allowed to leave the tiny space at night. Afterwards, she spent increasing amounts of time upstairs in the rest of the house, but each night was sent back to the chamber to sleep while the guy was at work.
Back to your chambers, peasant.
Yeah. In later years, she was seen outside in the garden, and then, after her 18th birthday, she was allowed to leave the house with the Priklopel. I can't pronounce his name. Took her on a skiing trip, a couple of hours away.
And they lived happily ever after.
Yeah, clearly.
Couple of kids.
Oh, dude. A large portion of her time was upstairs doing housework and cooking. And then a media advisor for the girl said that he would beat her so badly she would hardly walk. And when she was beaten black and blue, he tried to smarten her up. Then he would take his camera and photograph her. Then he would starve her to make her physically weak. So this is in her autobiography. So she wouldn't be able to escape. Her BMI had reached as low as 14.8, and normal BMI is 18.5 to 25. He told her that the doors and windows of the house were booby-trapped with high explosives, and he also said he had a gun at all times, and he'd kill her and the neighbours if she attempted to escape. And then eventually she escaped while she was vacuuming and cleaning.
The guy's car?
Yeah. The guy got a call on his mobile because of the vacuuming noise. Like, he walked away to take the call. She left the vacuum cleaner on and ran away and then called someone. Like, she ran, 200 meters through garden street fences, whatever, knocked on the window of some 71-year-old neighbor and said her name, says, "I'm Natasha," whatever. And then, they identified her. She weighed 48 kilos, right? And she weighed 45 kilos when she disappeared 8 years earlier.
Oh, so she weighed the same.
She grew 15 centimetres in 8 years. From, being a kid to being a teenager. 15 centimetres. Yeah.
All right, man. That's fucked up.
It's funny fucked. Dude, it's funny you brought that up. I listened to a podcast about a serial killer named Robin, if you'd like to jump on board.
Hang on, I'll finish this thing. The guy, knowing that the police were after him, killed himself by jumping in front of a train.
Dick.
He apparently planned to commit suicide rather than be caught having told the girl that they will not catch him alive.
Weak fuck.
Yeah.
What a weak cunt.
Yeah.
Rodney Alcala.
Who's that?
A serial killer. Alcala. Check this motherfucker out. I listened to it. Very interesting. It's this sick, sick fucking twisted freak.
I looked this up the other day, dude. I'm pretty sure I looked this up the other day. Was this on the Rogan podcast?
No. Oh, not that I know of. I listened to it on something else.
I think I looked this up the other day. That's trippy, because his name came up straight away on my thing, and it's, purple. Yeah, kid. So, Rodrigo Jacques Alcala Bucor, is his real name, is a convicted rapist and serial killer. He was sentenced to death in California in 2010 for 5 murders committed in the state between 77 and 79. In 2013, he received an additional sentence of 25 years to life after pleading guilty to 2 homicides in New York. His true victim count remains unknown and could be much higher.
Listen to this, right? Rodney Alcala was born in San Antonio in 1943, moved to LA at the age of 12. After a failed stint in the army, he enrolled in fine arts at UCLA and graduated in 1968, which is when he committed his first known crime. A murderer watched him lure an 8-year-old girl into his car and followed him back to his Hollywood apartment. When the police arrived, they found the girl had been raped, beaten, and was barely alive, but Alcala had somehow escaped. So basically, they walked in, they tended to the girl, and he just snuck out the back door.
Yeah.
Right? And then after that, right, he went and studied film under Roman Polanski. So Roman Polanski actually taught him how to use a camera and stuff, right?
I did look this up the other day. So that.
And then after that, he just continued to keep on killing and brutally murdering. He'd, get them to the point of, unconsciousness, and then they'd come back to life, and then he'd, do it all over again, torture them. Just, a sick freak, dude. But, yeah, linked with Roman Polanski. And Roman Polanski, as you know, drugged a 13-year-old girl and raped her.
Yeah.
And then when he was off on bail, he went back to France and they can't get him.
He and not just that. This is why it was familiar. Because the other day I was looking up, you know, you go on YouTube and you look up like the 10 most murderers and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, yeah.
I was eating lunch.
This is what you look up when you're having lunch?
Eating meat pie.
Yeah, I was having lunch. And because he was on a game show.
Yeah, during the midst...
I love game show.
Yeah, during the midst of his killing spree...
He went on a game show.
He made an appearance on a game show, on a dating game show.
And the girl didn't pick him because she thought he was too creepy.
Yeah. He got to the end, like, he won, he got to the end, and she's like, no, I don't want to have anything to do with him backstage. He freaked me out, like, I'm scared of him.
Yeah, and then on the actual YouTube thing, it said, you know, the commentator's like, well, she literally dodged a bullet.
How's that, man? But he just kept getting away with it, dude. Like,
fucked up, man. He's fucking...
And funnily enough, Roman Polanski's wife was killed by Charles Manson as well.
So yeah, I know like that
this,
one.
This
yeah,
crazy
yeah.
intertwining...
His wife, yeah, Sharon Tate, yeah. when she was pregnant.
Dude, so this guy and Roman Polanski are both creeps. Both escaped.
yeah, and Polanski's overseas now, so...
He's overseas. He's basically has a... He's a fugitive from America, so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
But isn't that the case, man? Like, these perpetrators... are doing this shit for, like, years until they finally push it too far or, like, you know, they leave a bloody glove or some shit at the scene or a sock filled with cum or some shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, dude, like Jill Maher's killer.
Mm.
He wasn't unknown to police. The guy was out on bail. Like, that's what I understand. Dude, I was reading somewhere the other day, like yesterday or the day before, I saw a headline, something about man who raped and killed a girl set free.
Yeah.
Like,
well, this same guy that I was just talking about, he was let off in bail after one of his murders, and he went straight out into New York and committed a crime, like, killed a girl straight
That's
away.
That's what I'm saying. Like, if you've got it in you...
Dude, why would they let him out? It's like letting a wild animal out.
If you accidentally kill someone because you're defending yourself, you know, or you're defending your wife, or you're defending, you know, someone on the street...
Life.
yeah, or, you know, someone breaks into your house and, you know, you kill them. Yeah, that's manslaughter, right? Like, you know, I didn't mean to fucking kill him. I was defending myself. It was my life or his, right? But if you willfully go and beat, like, a six-year-old girl in a submission, rape her, then, like, you know, throw her in a river, why, what planet would you be sane enough to be let out and do whatever you want?
Yeah.
I don't understand that.
Dude, the cops walked in, she was covered in blood and just, like, beaten to, like, near death. Yet still somehow this guy gets let out on bail and then goes commits another crime.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying.
What the fuck?
How does that happen?
Yeah, it shouldn't even like.
But at the same time, if I kick the shit out of a dog within an inch of its life,
I forget it.
I'll get thrown in prison.
15 years.
that's
not even a joke.
That's not even a joke.
Mm-hmm.
Just people seem to like people don't. I don't know why people don't make enough noise about it.
Damn dog.
No. Like, I don't understand it.
Yeah.
I do not understand it. How do people not make noise about it? Like, to the point where, are you out of your fucking mind? Like, how can you let someone out that's brutally raped and killed someone?
Yeah, there should be just some kind of no tolerance.
Yeah.
With that.
You want, yeah, like, we're worried about gays, like, getting married. Like, really?
Mm.
What about the cunts that, like, literally beat women and children in a submission?
And then roam the streets.
Mm.
Yeah, or, you know, when... Like, a sex predator gets done for, you know, grooming children, and then they let him out under supervision. Oh, he's got strict parole conditions.
Yeah.
Dude, what?
He can walk out at 6 o'clock, go to his neighbour and brutally murder them.
Yeah.
Who's watching him?
He can go for a walk. Oh, he's not allowed within 200 metres of any school facilities. I'm pretty sure children aren't just locked to schools and bedrooms. Yeah. Like, they do walk the streets.
Yeah. They don't all live 200
metres. Is he allowed to go to the park? Is he allowed to go to the pools? Is he allowed to go to the beach?
Supermarket?
Yeah. Is he allowed to go buy milk or is someone buying the milk for him?
It's like, at taxpayers' expense.
Yeah. If these fucking sickos get released to the streets, right, then what are they doing? Are they productive members of society? No, they're just flying under the radar and let to just exist. Yeah? Are they allowed to work?
No.
No, I'm being honest.
Like a Centrelink benefit or like
pension. Convicted felon pension.
Bad behaviour pension.
I don't think they're allowed any money As in they get things
brought to
them.
Oh, so their utilities are paid for them.
Everything's done for them.
Oh, so is that the answer to life now? Sexually molest someone so you can get utilities paid for the rest of your life.
You want to pay my electricity bill?
Yeah, so I touched a kid at the park. Yeah, no, I'm serious. Dude, I was explaining this to Jose yesterday. I went for dinner with a mate. I can't remember how old. Oh, we're talking about body corporate fees and shit. He's going to VCAT, right? And I'm like, so what happens? He goes, well, not going to throw me in jail. Okay, relax. Okay, they're not going to throw you in jail. Not over a few $1,000, you know, owing on body corporate. And he's like, no, they won't. I go, dude, okay, that fucking Channel 9 reporter, he got busted for, you know, expressing pedophilic thoughts over the internet. He got 3 years suspended sentence and a $1,000 fine.
You'll be okay.
Yeah, meanwhile, I got $450 fine and a year suspended sentence for running a red light. You know, it's funny how, you know, he said he's got that serial killer look.
Yeah.
I was going to say, dude, you both have worked in warehouses, right? Mm. So you'd probably...
Never.
I met you in a warehouse.
What's a warehouse?
I was going to say, I don't know, maybe it's just me, like, paying too much attention, but it just seems like there's always these stock prototypes of, like, workers that come and join the ranks. As in, like, just cookie cutter, you can already spot the personality or just the look of, like, the head.
The raggy dolls.
Yeah, do you understand what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. Every time, like you see them, like the standard token workers in every warehouse, yeah? And there's two that always pop up because we're just at the end of the recruitment drive, you know, over like Christmas. Mm. Now they're starting to cull the numbers again, like getting rid of all the dead weight. So I'm just starting to notice more people that have either gone missing or people that are still around. Like, oh yeah, this guy, like, no, I thought he'd be out of here by now.
He made it through, wow.
Yeah.
Surprise.
Literally, dude, there's two heads. Actually, there's three heads standard every fucking year. It doesn't matter which joint I've worked in, but in the warehouses, they're always in them, man. I don't know if you guys have seen them before. There's the one guy that always looks, he's always a short bloke, usually wears like a beanie or a hat pulled really low. Usually got an odd tat or two, but almost always has like a goatee or a mo. And he just puts his head down, works without giving a fuck about anyone else. And he's the guy where it's like, you know, you try and tell him to do something. He's like, mind your own business. I'm not here to make mates or some shit.
Yeah.
Then usually pisses someone off and then gets a sack after about a month.
The selfish lone wolf, I call him.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
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 There's always that, right? So I nearly ran over someone the other day on the fork. He was like ducking in and out. And I've like slammed the brakes. He's just like jumped in front of the fork to put a crate down. I'm like, fucking really, man? Like, and he's looked at me like I'm a piece of shit. I'm like, dude, like I'm not doing anything dangerous. Then there's always another guy that looks like the fucking Zodiac killer. Do you ever watch Jake Gyllenhaal that was in the Zodiac?
Jakey. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you remember the main guy that they said was the perp? He's the guy that plays Drew Carey's brother on Drew Carey's show. I keep forgetting the actor's name.
I think I do. I'm going to bring a picture of him just so I can refresh my memory banks, Dimitri.
Yeah, I won't describe him yet, but anyone that's listening to this, like, you know, if they don't want to Google it, I'll describe him once you look it up. he plays the main guy that they tried to catch as the Zodiac Killer, because the Zodiac Killer has never been caught to this day. Yeah? And in the movie... This guy was that actor that played Drew Carey's brother on the Drew Carey show. He plays the main guy that they allege was the killer.
This guy?
Yeah. Dude, there's always a guy. He's usually sort of a big bloke, balding, glasses, sweating profusely.
Yes, always.
And he's usually got a chip on his shoulder as well. But he's like silent.
The sweat hog, I call him.
Yeah. That's like a standard prototype for a factory warehouse.
Dude. I used to work with a guy at the pharmaceutical company I was telling you about, right? And I was trying to figure out his fucking name and who he looked like.
Yeah.
He looks like this guy in that movie, No Country for Old Men.
Yeah. Oh.
Killer.
Yeah.
Dude, he used to walk in and not say a word, dude. He used to walk in, right? Get his little, you know, headpiece and whatever.
Yeah. Dude, oh, you use the same headsets we do. Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
And then he'd sit in the corner, have his lunch, and his lunch would be the fucking same thing every day, man. Like, repetitive serial killer stuff, man.
Yeah.
Like, just sandwich,
OCD.
Crust cut off.
OCD style.
Fucked up, man. Like, you sit there and just, like, and look straight ahead.
I love how this is the fucked up thing. Like, the guy eating his meal.
And then a crust cut off.
Yeah.
It looks like that Javier fucking Bardem guy in that No Country for Old Men. And then he'd never said, in the 3 years that I worked there, I'd never even see him talk to anyone.
Yeah.
He'd just walk in. Everyone just stay away from him.
He uses a voice system to pick, but yeah. he'd never spoken a single word to anyone. No. It's like, I've expended all my vocabulary for today. Yeah. I've no more energy for people.
He'll talk into the thing, but I never heard him have a conversation.
Yeah.
He'd have a really deep voice.
They're the ones you got to watch out for.
Dude, he's fucking creepy. I thought, man, this guy's going to pull out a fucking shovel or something out of his boot and just knock someone out with a shovel. Like, not even a gun.
Nick does a late shift one day, and then he's driving home, and as he stopped on, like, Wellington Road, looks out the window, sees this guy standing over a ditch
mate,
with a shovel.
You know what I'd do?
Near the M1 on ramp.
Yeah.
Where those trees are.
Mate, I'd accelerate and never look back. I wouldn't go back to the job.
Yeah, dead set.
Take off.
Work tries to call him for 3 days, finally get a hold of him. Where are you? I'm never coming back. Why? You change your staff.
Yeah.
Get creeped out.
Something's fucked up in there.
That's it. There's always a Zodiac killer. Like, that's a standard prototype. So
what's your third stereotype?
The third one, and I don't give a fuck. The only way I can describe him, because I've only seen this movie once when I was a kid, but the one thing, I remember two scenes from that movie, and this is the one thing I remember from it. Did you ever watch Fear with Mark Wahlberg?
Yeah, I love that movie.
Of course you do. Of course you do, speaking about sexually violent guys, sexually aggressive guys.
Reese Witherspoon.
Yeah. Reese Witherspoon and Alyssa Milano.
Mm.
Yeah. Do you remember her stepdad? Is it a stepdad or it's a stepdad, I'm pretty sure.
Stepdad.
Yeah, with the glasses.
Mm.
Yeah, there's always a guy who looks exactly like him, man. And same fucking temperament, just staunch, doesn't say a word to anyone, and probably thinks he's above the job that he's doing.
Mm.
He's always got glasses and like a short fucking haircut. Yeah, not even a... he looks like Reese Witherspoon's dad in Fear.
I gotta look it up now.
I'm telling you, man. Because there's one guy that just started working with us a couple of weeks ago.
It's that guy.
And I was walking around with some paperwork. I was looking for something. I don't know what I was doing. And he's nearly run me over, and I've just looked at him, and he's just driven past like I wasn't even there. Like, are you serious, dude? And he's always like...
That dude?
Yeah! He looks like that.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
I'm telling you.
It's crazy as all hell.
Yeah, if you see him from that movie with the... Because that Mark Wahlberg movie was like an early 90s movie, was it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Yeah.
90s, what's the word for it? The genre?
Thriller.
90s thriller. Yeah. They're my favorite. That's my favorite kind. Lots of good thrillers in the 90s.
Everyone was starting to catch on to that whole sort of thing.
Michael Douglas was in a few beauties.
Beauties.
I think that's all he did in the 90s was thrillers. It's like the high-powered exec.
Yeah, man.
Like,
Douglas, man.
Hang on. William Peterson.
Oh, here you go. It came up. Cape Fear.
No, not Cape Fear. It's Fear. William Peterson is the dad.
No, sorry. It's another 90s thriller, yeah. Cape Fear.
Oh, yeah. Dude, hang on. Wait a second. I'll see if I got a photo of him.
Maybe my picture was
from Cape like Fear. This guy. They all look like him. They all look like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Glasses.
Yeah.
Just flat top.
And you know what? Always made that skivvy.
Yeah. Dude, I'm not even joking.
Yeah, skivvy.
That's like the standard prototype workers.
Yeah. Skivvy slacks.
I've worked in warehouses a lot, man, and I'm telling you, those three heads pop up every fucking time.
It's always one of those.
Dude, it just gets me angry, it gets me creeped out.
There's always one guy that's too clean.
Yeah, I've said that.
Yeah.
Too organized, too clean.
Yeah, and you're like...
To be blue collar.
Dude, like, smells like you literally walked out of a hospital, man.
Yeah. You think, what the fuck?
Continually,
But that's weird, like, it's... But like, yeah, I know. Never a mark on him. Never like.
Nah, clothes are brand new.
Yeah. Like he opens a pack every day of new clothes.
Yeah. Mm. Like literally gave himself a colon cleansing before I left the house.
Mm.
Like.
Carries little satchels of hand disinfectant.
I'm not even joking. That's exactly right. I'm not even joking, man. There are. That's standard. And for a warehouse setting. Like, dude, there are guys in there that don't wash their clothes for, like, weeks. You know what I mean?
Your hands are supposed to get dirty in a warehouse setting.
Yeah, these cunts look like they just walked out.
In a warehouse. You're going to get dirty.
They look like they just got opened up from, like, a packet of, something off a shelf.
Yeah.
Like a brand new pack, like, and then thrown into the warehouse.
Mm.
You know what, man? I think everyone should work in a warehouse industrial setting at some point in their life. Being forced to clock on, clock off.
Just to see what rock bottom is.
Yeah.
How robotic.
Just, yeah.
How fucking...
Because, dude, I know people that have worked in corporate their entire lives. Like, you know, after high school, went to uni, then they got their work experience in corporate settings.
Well, they've never had their hands dirty.
Yeah, look, I'm not taking away from corporate work.
No, right? But I'm saying they never...
I'm just saying they've never had to clock on and clock off. They've never had to have their toilet breaks monitored. They've never had...
Never experienced a callus.
Yeah, 15 minutes for smoko, that's it. You know what I mean? Like, they've never worked to a percentage where your KPI is literally a computer screaming numbers at you.
It's not like you're in an office and it's like, I'm just going to go make myself a coffee. Oh, you're in a warehouse. Can I go make a coffee? Get out!
No food or...
Get back to the belt.
Yeah. Where's your yellow vest? Where's your safety boots? Where is this? Where's that? Smoko? Yeah, Smoko's at 8:45 to 10 o'clock. But it takes 5 minutes to walk outside to the smoking yard. Well...
10 o'clock.
No, I'm serious. Because I know a lot of people, man, they've never worked there. Like, I explain some of the jobs I've had, you know, and they look at me like, who would work like this? Like, most of the world.
Yeah.
Well, dude, what percentage of workers... Look it up if it's a statistic. How many people in the world work... low skill,
blue collar.
Yeah, blue collar jobs.
I'll put in how many blue
collar. Low skill, but like we're not talking about, you know, tradies doing carpentry work because that's blue collar work.
We're talking bottom barrel. We're talking bottom barrel collar.
We're talking like.
Oh, look, I've got how many blue collar workers in Australia? Talk amongst yourselves. I've got the Bureau of Statistics.
I'm going to say they outnumber white collar.
You think so?
Yeah.
You know what's the strange thing is, man? People like us, it's weird how, like, people are always stressing about jobs, how there are no jobs, but you always see these fucking blue-collar jobs on Seek, picking, packing job in Clayton, you know, for $17.80 an hour.
Yeah.
You know, some shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, it's like there's no shortage of these jobs where everyone's unemployed.
Must be able to work in an assembly line.
Yeah. I don't get it.
What's this here? White-collar workers are the big winners in job market.
Oh, really?
Is that a surprise?
I'm stunned.
So, apparently, it says here 2.5 million Australians belong to a trade union, and a further 1.5 million want to join them. So, we're talking that's builders. So, let's say
3 million tradies.
Yeah. 3 million tradies. That's just tradies, though. That's not warehouse workers.
No, we're talking about low-skilled.
Yeah, it's not giving me a number because they're trying to hide the fact.
Yeah.
So, it says here... So, I'd say over 60%. That's the way it works. The way the world works. You can't just have everyone being white collar. I'm saying over 60%.
Have you seen the thing that's gone on with Trump and the DACA repeal in America? DACA, you know, the Dreamers?
Yeah.
How they want to change. Trump is trying to get rid of the protective status of, like, the Dreamers and, like, kids that were taken to the States at a young age or born there, but their parents were, like, either illegal immigrants or...
Okay.
Yeah. You haven't seen everything that's gone on with it?
No.
It's in its last legs, yeah. Basically, the last couple of days, I've been watching a lot of CNN sort of editorial replies and shit like that to, like, all the Trump stuff. Did you see the shithole country thing?
Yeah.
That's a joke.
How he's not going to get done for that, I don't understand.
How can you declare that... Africa countries as a whole,
shithole.
They're all shithole countries. Yeah. Haitians are from
this is the president of the free world.
Okay.
This is the president of the United States, dude.
Yeah. But, like, it's something that, like, a lot of common people would just think. Yeah,
okay, but he doesn't have to come out of the mouth of the president.
These are the things that I've been watching, right? He's saying that...
Maybe the president needs to do that just to make it fucking aware that we have fucking, there's a crisis.
And maybe. What, the kid in Africa goes, I know it's a shithole. What are you telling me for?
Wait a second, Johnny, because this is where you're going to go off track, right? And this is where a lot of people...
Because I've been listening to some like counter arguments. Yeah, okay. You know, so... Yeah.
No, cool, bring them. This is what... In essence, this is what's wrong with what Trump said, right? In essence, this is what's wrong, okay? Number one, his facts are fucking way off. Right, because he's coming out and saying that we have to end this lottery-based immigration thing. These countries are sending their worst, and we're getting these people that are useless, and we're bringing them into our country. CNN did an editorial reply to it, like a facts check reply, yeah? Watch it with, I think it's with Cooper, what's his name? Cooper Anderson or whatever. Mm. He did a fact check on all this, right? It's like, okay, this is where it's wrong, because he's putting this out to all these pro-Trumpers, right, to stir up the pot to gain support, when what he's saying is completely inaccurate. The majority, firstly, in order to get into a lottery-based immigration deal, like from another country, right? Like, say, like go to South Africa or Nigeria or wherever, yeah? Firstly, they get screened on their end. You can't just be a criminal looking to get on a boat out of there and put your hand up and say, I'm going to America. It doesn't work like that. The biggest, like, in America, I was looking up the stats. If you look them up, man, just to verify it, the biggest, like, it's something like 25% of Americans have, like, a high school diploma. X percent of Americans have a bachelor or, like, in a higher advanced learning diploma. There are a bigger percentage of Nigerian migrants coming here, to America, with bachelors and doctorates than there are in America.
Mm.
So, like, in order first to get screened, they get screened on that end first. It's like, we don't want... You can't be a shit cunt or a criminal. You get screened for, like, criminal convictions, you know, all that sort of shit, yeah? Education, criminal... You need to have at least a high school diploma or equivalent of, like, 2-3 years work experience, et cetera, et cetera. So you get screened on that end to come to go to America.
Do you think their screening process is, like, completely thorough? Like,
why wouldn't it be? These aren't... They're not coming from... They're not coming from... what's it called? Countries rife in civil war. They're going from developed countries, man. Go to Nigeria. Go to South Africa. We've got millionaires and doctors. That's the point. The percentage of them leaving the country, putting their hands up to leave, have got fucking doctorates and bachelors and, you know, education and shit behind them. Secondly, then when they get to America, they're screened again. The same fucking thorough screening process goes on in the States. So the American government rescreens the already screened applicants and then monitors them for like a year or two. Trump is making it out like, oh, you know, the Congo is just going into their prisons, grabbing the 1,000 worst, you know, offenders and then throwing them on a plane and then America's accepting them. It doesn't work like that. It does not work like that. And that's what Trump's putting up. And if you've got that kind of propaganda starting at the top of the fucking table, at the top of the pyramid, what does that say, man? It's completely misleading. And like Trump's campaign has been, completely misleading. No wall. He said he would protect the middle-income earners. Bullshit. His tax repeals are protecting all the high earners. You know what I mean? Like, he's done a 180 on everything. He's fucking lied about everything to this point. And that's what first of all, the DACA thing, that's one part. Second part, I was watching about... Because I was talking to a friend who's from El Salvador. I didn't know she was from El Salvador. She was Hispanic somewhere, but I didn't know it was El Salvador.
Mexico.
Yeah. And she sent me a message saying how her mom had started saying how Trump had listed El Salvador as one of the shithole countries. Haitians have got a protected status in the States because of the earthquake, you know, that happened. The whole country's still rife. Like, it was fucked up before that.
I know. Trump's still handing a paper towel.
Yeah. But Haitians have a protective status in the States, right? Like, as... You know, they said, come down. Like, you're not going to be hassled about fucking this and that because you got nowhere to go. Like, your house was destroyed. Your economy's fucked. Blah, blah, blah. And now they want to remove that within the next 12 months. Yeah. And then he listed, you know, see, this is where his argument gets skewed, right? Because they haven't come out and denied what he said. Or he hasn't apologized to what he said. He just beat around the bush as in, like, he beat around the bush saying it's not accurate. But he didn't actually deny what he said. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's a thing regarding racism and there's a thing regarding just ignorance. Now, and just plain fucking, like, what's it called? Lack of empathy, right? Because he doesn't actually understand how it works. He cites saying, why are we getting countries from... He said that all Haitians have AIDS. Like, literally. Literally, all Haitians have AIDS.
Every person that lives in that country has AIDS.
Forget the fact that Haiti was fucking wiped out by Americans how many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Forget all the civil wars and shit that's happened. Forget all the crap that's devastated Haitians, yet they stand up and fucking keep fighting to survive, right? But he listed, like, El Salvador, Haiti, Nigeria, and then he said, why can't we go and get migrants from Norway? There are no black people in Norway. They're the whitest people on the planet. The lottery, the migration lottery in America doesn't go to countries with mass influx. The lottery doesn't go to the Mexicans because there are Mexican immigrants. They're bordering, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They go to countries with the least amount of migrants in order to create diversity and prosperity and new wave of commerce and new wave of communities. America is a multicultural country the way Australia is, yeah? But Trump doesn't want countries from... He doesn't see Africa as, like, countries. He sees Africa as one country. It's a fucking continent. You're telling me they're rife, like, dude, Zimbabwe up until the last, you know, 10, 20 years was the breadbasket of fucking Africa. South Africa, full of fucking millionaires and diplomats and doctors.
Man. Look at the cricket team.
Yeah. But do you understand what I'm saying? In Trump's head, they're all just black from Africa and they're all useless. Like, but then he makes a comparison with the Chinese, how he says, oh, you know, there are heaps of Chinese migrants that are, like, prosperous and blah, 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 blah. But he doesn't differentiate between, not even Chinese, it's Asians. He doesn't even know, like, what you're saying, there are no Asian countries that have got skewed governments or rife economies? There are. So he's happy to accept Asians because they're all Asian. Didn't say Asia, didn't say Southeast Asia, didn't say Asia Minor, just said Asians because they're all Asian.
Like, it's so...
Right? He made that clear divide, yeah, but he's not happy to... you know what I mean? There are countries in Asia that have fucking got rife governments.
Myanmar.
And corruption. Yeah, like corruption. But he doesn't differentiate between who Asians are and who Africans are, but then puts all the Africans as shithole nations, even though some of the world's biggest fucking trading, commerce, and blah, 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 capitalists come from the continent of Africa.
Does he realize the coffee that he drinks?
Exactly. Brazilian or fucking African?
African. It's one or the other.
Yeah, right? But then wants people from Norway. There are no Africans, no black people. They're just white.
Like, you can't deny now that racism plays a big part in his leadership.
And then in that turn... Then there's also, like, I was watching a thing because that friend of mine's from El Salvador. She came here to Australia when she was 5 because she was escaping the civil war. Yeah, like, dude at work, you know, when I asked him if he'd gone back to El Salvador, he's been here like 28, 25 years or whatever it is. He's like, what for? Get shot because the government's fucked. Like, no way. Like, I'm back there. I've got a life here now. Like, I came here and worked and I've got everything. Like, why would I go back? He's an Australian from El Salvador. Like, that friend of mine who's an Australian from El Salvador. Like, that's how it is. I was watching this thing on CNN where they were talking about a guy who lived in the States. He'd gone there, you know, in his late teens or whatever it is, yeah, however old he was. He'd spent 20-odd years in the States. He'd had 3 kids and now is facing deportation back to El Salvador, right, for whatever reason. But he's got 3 kids that were born and raised in the States. 2 of them had gone to El Salvador twice, you know, and then his youngest had gone for the first time for the purpose of that interview. This guy is now working stupid hours in the States and using whatever he has to go back to El Salvador to build a house should he get sent back there at some point.
So he's got a roof over his head.
To take his 3 kids who don't know a thing about the country just because. Just because. How is that fair? I was reading about a Mexican guy that just got sent back to Mexico because he failed to have the proper... Like, I can't remember the appeal. Hang on. I'll see if I've screenshotted it.
Well, I was actually watching a doco yesterday saying a lot of the Mexican deportees now are going to, like, Tijuana and they're working in call centers because they speak English. They're bilingual. You know what I mean? And it's fucked up. They're like, of course we want to be back in America. But... And it's like a lot of the people that are getting deported are on, like, bullshit, like... What do they say, like, for a traffic offense? Oh, you're going back to Mexico. Any little excuse now, they're back. Going back. That's fucked up, man. Any words about your boy Trump?
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, it's getting ridiculous yeah. Now.
This is one of the things that I read. New Jersey couple deported to Mexico after 30 years in the U.S. leaving family
come on,
behind.
Man.
A couple from New Jersey... Who came to New Jersey from Mexico 30 years ago have been deported, leaving their 3 children behind. Oscar and Humberto Campos lived in Bridgeton, New Jersey, and own a landscaping company. They said goodbye to their children at Newark Airport before boarding a flight to Mexico. Their children, aged 16, 22, and 24, are all American citizens. He fled violence in his hometown and crossed the border into Texas in 89. After a lengthy effort to obtain work visas, the couple were ordered by immigration officials to leave the country. A senator from New Jersey tried to help the family stay in the U.S., but extremely disappointed, blah, blah, blah.
They can own a business?
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. Come on, man. Come on, Johnny. Look at you.
That's the thing. All these citizens are like stand-up citizens.
They got their own businesses. They pay their taxes.
Poverty. Like, they had nothing, you know, and they escaped poverty. That's like the American dream. There's a Haitian senator from, where was she from? I can't remember. It was another CNN editorial, and she's a Republican, and she's extremely disappointed in what Trump said. Her parents, who told Trump personally they're praying for his victory, like, have spent their entire time crying now because he's come out and said all Haitians have AIDS and need to be removed. Literally.
Like, what kind of president says that
shit? Yeah, the Haitian American senator said, she goes, I'm a first generation Haitian American. She goes, my parents came here with nothing, fought, hammer and tooth that have us, like, have a family and put us through education. Their daughter is now a senator or whatever, you know, in the American thing. Yeah.
Senate.
Yeah, American Senate or whatever, American government. She goes, I am the American dream, that someone can come here from nothing, with nothing, and build something for themselves. She goes, I am the American dream. And now Trump says that we all have AIDS and we need to get sent back. Because we're from shithole nations.
Does he realize this is not a reality show? It can't be edited?
Yeah.
Yeah? This is like, whatever he says gets quoted and...
He doesn't.
That's fucked up.
Did he actually say they all have AIDS?
Yeah, dude.
Yes. These are quotes.
Quote, unquote.
Johnny, these are quotes. I've been watching these for the last 3-4 days in the hours before I go to work.
I just never saw that one.
He's fucked up. It's fucked up.
Dude, he has said some of the most vile shit, and that's where they're calling it like now. It's like, dude, that is... To say that all Africans are from shithole countries, and then, you know, all these Central American countries, they're shithole countries, and, you know, why are we taking people in? And then to come out with all... And then, oh, we should be taking people from Norway. Why? Norwegians don't want to go to America. No,
they've got a cool country as it is.
As in, there's no reason for them to leave. They're not looking to fucking leave. Look, do you know what I mean?
Just to play devil's advocate, though, right?
All
right. Like, they are fleeing their country because, I mean, their country's not great, right?
For whatever reason. We're not just talking about... We're not talking about asylum seekers.
We're not talking about immigrants. Like,
we're just talking about...
People that want to better themselves.
He wants to end the migration policy, of like the lottery-based policy. But he thinks it's literally, you know...
We're taking crims.
Corrupt officials in, you know, Venezuela are going into a prison, extracting all the fucking sickos.
And going, hey, man.
On a plane and then sending them to America.
That's not what's happening.
It doesn't work like that. If you look at the statistics, the biggest... There are more graduates and for advanced... education graduates leaving countries like Nigeria, etc., etc., to go to America. They're screened at that end, and then they're screened and monitored on the other end. Trump has it in his head, like they're just rolling the dice and plucking all these serial killers from, like, Mexican prisons. Well, it doesn't work like that. It literally doesn't work like that. But he's creating the hyperbole that it does in order to get all the racists and rednecks to jump up and say, yeah, we need to end it. Dude... You need a young wave of foreign fucking influence and money to come in because that's what keeps the economy going. All the fucking people in America, all the older generation are dying out. All these old farts in the Rust Belt or like in Florida.
Like, they're all gone.
They're going to go. And there's not going to be anything new coming in because he's fucking keeping everyone out. It doesn't work like that. This is 2018. We rely on migration now. We rely on, like...
Told you, America's going to turn into, like, the Mad Max movie.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
And they're going to do it to themselves.
Well, the other side of the argument is, right, like, with immigration, like, when you're taking a group of people from a country that's completely different to yours, with different laws, like, they just have a different ideology about everything, right? And you just try and integrate them into another society, it's going to cause, like... There's going to be butting heads.
How did your old man live in Thailand?
What do you mean?
How did your old man live in Thailand?
And his father opened up a business there.
They went from England to Thailand. I'm pretty sure there's a big difference between Southeast Asia and starchy Britain.
They had the business. They prospered. Your old man integrated and had to and did it well.
And this is the other thing. They're not going. They're not going to the middle of fucking... Nah. Rwandan camps to extract.
Dude, this is America.
The people that are putting their hands up for migration are people that are educated in Western universities, mind you, that are fucking semi-prosperous that want to fucking exceed. They're not taking harems and fucking tribal paint and saying, "All right, New Yorkers, you all have to fucking do what we do now."
No, this is a kid that went through uni.
These are people,
proper college,
educated in a Western fucking university.
School,
to go to live the American dream that they've always read about.
And another thing, for them to come into the country, they have to know English. These people know English.
They're doctors.
That's what I'm saying.
And that's the thing. The percentage of Americans having the standard of education that these migrants, these potential migrants are looking for, also have, they don't have it. On paper, literally, dude. And that's where it's insanity. That's where it doesn't make any fucking sense. It's literally just Trump living in his stuffy fucking world where he thinks it's the way it was in the 20s and 30s. And that's where they're headed.
I mean, all the immigrants aren't, like, upstanding, like, people with degrees and stuff, right? It is, like, just common people.
No, that's the point. As in, like, when they get screened, right, depending where they're coming from, they're screened as having, you know, there's a minimum, you know, of like you need a high school diploma or like, you know, you
no criminal record.
You can't just come off the streets, be a junkie or have fucking, yeah, be spend 10 years in the slammer and say, yeah, I'm going to America now.
Yeah, there's minimum requirements. That there's you have requirements, to pass. Dude. It's a test. It's actually a test.
Dude,
but I mean, that's really what he wants to stop, right? It's just like.
No, what he wants to stop is completely deluded and misguided because he doesn't actually understand the way the system works because he's got it in his head. He thinks that migration is what's killed the American economy when he doesn't actually understand it. He sees the world as he sees it. In his little bubble, he has his fucking figments of his imagination, right? But then he thinks that he's going to apply it to real world, real life. It's like, dude, the world is not as you see it. That's what they're saying. Dude, he's senile. He's going fucking senile.
They actually just did his health test.
Oh, did they?
All clear.
Yeah.
In fine health.
Clearly.
You're going to tell the president otherwise.
Did you see him having the fucking did you see him having that cabinet meeting where full of Dems and Republicans and then the Democrats are like, look, can we just agree to get a clean DACA bill right now and then we'll take care of everything else? Like, you know, can we just get this over and done with? And then, like, Trump's agreeing with the Democrat, and then the Republican Senator's like, oh, Mr. President, you do realize that they want this, this, and that. He's like, oh, no, it seems like we're all on the same page. Like, he's agreeing with whoever's
talking. He has no idea what's going on.
Yeah. Dude, his mental health is going off the fucking rail. If you watch these fucking interviews, you just stare and say, this guy's out of his mind. He'll agree with what someone says, because he has no idea what they're saying, and then he'll get reminded by someone on his own camp, oh, but what about things? Oh, yeah, maybe that too. And then he just... It will change your conversation to something else just to move on it so it doesn't look
like an idiot. He knows who's a Democrat and who's a Republican.
No, he's lost, like, that, what's her name, is it Warren's, the Democratic thing, senator from down south? Like, dude, he's lost all fucking grip. But the dangerous part is the message that, like, he puts out, which creates that hyperbole and that fucking blind ignorance, man. Dude, Greeks, I told you in the past, okay, Greeks are so fucking ridiculous. Like, the older generation, like, say, Nick and I's parents, they have these skewed ideas of what, like, other cultures around them are about, and I've spent how much time arguing with them.
Trying to tell them, but yeah, it's not fucking
like that, man.
Let me teach you, like, not telling them, let me enlighten you, and let me educate you on what it's really like, and they don't want nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
They're like, nah, fuck it, nah.
This is one of the best examples of fucking wives tale and stupid folklore which casts a shadow on like an entire culture of people. I remember being a kid and being told by like maybe not my parents but just hearing it around like the dinner table or somewhere that Middle Easterns or like South Asians, if you don't burp after your meal, it's considered rude.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah, you've heard it too. Dude, I got how many Arab friends, man? And we're talking Lebanese, Syrian, Egyptian, like, you know, all over the joint. They will fucking tell you outright, if anyone caught you burping at the fucking table, you get beaten to death. You would get, that's the biggest taboo in the world. Like, are you out of your fucking mind? Like, that's insane. But there's a whole generation of fucking... Greeks and Italians out there
believe that
that's actually how it is. That's just a tiny little thing. But imagine that shit. Like, that's just a tiny little thing, man, is in the perception of another culture. And you got the top of the chain, like Trump, telling people that, oh, we've got to end this lottery. We're getting there worse. It's like, dude, what are you talking about? They're screened twice, not just by their government, but your government.
Because if they don't once they get to the States and they get screened and they fail, they send them straight back.
Yeah. It's like, dude, you can't speak English. You're a career criminal with no education.
Bye.
Literally.
You're fired.
Yes. You need to have sponsorship over there, man. I don't know how many people that have moved over there permanently. And they had to have... Dude, Nick, my cousin, who is now a writer for ESPN.
Yeah.
Before he left, like, he's done nothing but work, right? Before he left, even I wrote him a letter of recommendation because when we're running the media company to prove that he had work to come back to in Australia just so he wouldn't be a burden on their economy. Like, there was no chance of him ever leaning on their government for, you know, aid.
Benefits.
Yeah, benefits and aid. Literally. As in, he came to me and got my paperwork just to add a bit more weight to his thing. So, yeah, dude, relax. Look, you know, you got to prove that you're not going there just to leech off him. And you're actually a functioning member of society. This was before he's... And he hadn't even become a... He's not even a citizen.
Is he going to try and become a citizen?
I don't know. His missus is American. So I'm guessing if they, like, hook up permanently, then But this was just to get a working visa, just to prove, like, not even a working, I think it was a working visa slash extended residency sort of visa, you know what I mean? Like, so he could earn money and not do it. He wanted to do everything right. He didn't want to just go there and just hang around, you know? He wanted everything documented, so in case he ever did move there permanently, which was his ultimate goal, he wanted to have something to backfall on, you know?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. They keep saying it over and over again. Trump had no idea what he was doing when he took up the presidency because he had no idea this is how much work it actually encompassed. And but the facts checking, man, the amount of lies that he just keeps putting forward, people are taking as gospel. It doesn't work, man. It's not like that. How many lies have you heard about, like, you know, other people's cultures, like in your entire lifetime? But the difference is Trump's got literally the chair to say whatever he wants, and the world's going to hear it.
Dangerous.
It's fucking dangerous.